Hello students, today we will talk about research. So let's begin with the word research and what does it mean. The word research is made up of two syllables, re and search. The prefix re means again, something new, something fresh, and search means to examine, to test, to probe. Together, research is a planned, systematic and scientific investigation in a field of knowledge undertaken to find answers to problems. So there are several definitions of research. One such definition is given by George A. Lundberg in 1942 in his book called Social Research, A Study in Methods of Gathering Data. And he has given a very simple definition by pointing out that research is a scientific method consisting of observation, classification and interpretation of data. So, observation, classification and interpretation of any kind of collected data. Then the very recent definitions are given by Roger Wimmer and Joseph Dominic. It was in a book written in 2011. They have given a very scientific definition of research by saying that research is an organized, objective, controlled, qualitative and quantitative empirical analysis of one or more variable. Let me repeat. An organized, objective, controlled, qualitative or quantitative empirical analysis of one or more variables. So these definitions illustrate the constituents of scientific research, which form the core characteristics. According to Wimmer and Dominic, the scientific research has five characteristics. First, that research is public. What does it mean? It clearly means that research should be accessible to all, accessible in a public domain. For further studies, and people can and research should mention all the facts and datas which are verifiable. People can go and verify these datas. Second is research should be objective. There should be no biases attached to it. The word objective refers to reality, that is actual, authentic or definite. So it should be away from any kind of prejudices or subjectivity. Third is research is empirical. The word empirical denotes information or data gathered by experience, observation or experiment. Thus, in empirical research, data is collected through observation and experiments, and the findings reflect what is observed in real life situations. So you go, you observe what is happening around you, you talk to people, you collect data, and this kind of research is empirical research, which there is a tendency of when you look at things, when you observe things, there can be some subjectivity, and which can lead to an error, conclusions with error. So objectivity and empiricism aspect are two important interrelated features. So reliability and validity. Reliability is the quality of being reliable. A reliable tool or method will be consistent in yielding accurate results on repeated measures under same conditions and with same subjects. And validity is the extent to which an instrument measures what it is supposed to measure and performs as it is designed to perform. Am I making myself clear? Right. So moving on to next fourth point, they mentioned that research is systematic and cumulative. Scientific research is systematic in all stages. That means from the conception of planning to data collection, to analysis, to report writing, everything has a systematic pattern, right? Every research in some way is cumulative, as it draws from previous studies, which is known as in which we talk about the areas in which already this study has been done, and we use our review of literature to understand that what kind of study has already been done. So therefore, research has a cumulative quality. Then research is predictive. Fifth point given by Wimmer and Dominic is research is predictive. Research often helps in relating the present to the future. Research often helps in relating the present situations to the future situations. The research findings and the ensuing theories help scientists make predictions. As Wimmer and Dominic in their book also says that a theory's adequacy lies in its ability to predict a phenomenon or an event successfully. This statement has been given on their page 13 of the book. Here, it must be noted that certain types of research studies are conducted to predict the outcomes of an event or an issue. For instance, opinion polls and exit polls are designed to predict the outcome of elections. So what are opinion polls? They are kind of research, right? So in some research, be it in any field, must be empirical, objective, organized and systematic to obtain valuable results.